One morning, my sister and I were sitting on the couch watching The Price is Right. When my sister pulled out a state ID that she had gotten the day before. "Don't I look just like Eileen Wuornos?" she said as she handed me the ID. I told the lady at the DMV that when I show my ID at the bank, the teller is going to say, "Well, hello, Eileen, we thought they killed you." I looked over the photo and then handed it back to her. It isn't a perfect resemblance, but I look so hardened. "Yeah, but you don't really look like..." "I look like Ma Barker, that's what I look like." "Yeah, or maybe Eileen's sister, but not so much like Eileen herself. I need a facelift bad. Do you know any plastic surgeons or anyone who has gone to a good one? I really need a good one." I lit up a cigarette and rested it in an ashtray on my knee. "Do you want one that can make you look more or less like Eileen Wuornos?" "Less, less. I can look like her, look more like her on my own." We both laughed, and then my sister grabbed her remote. "I can't stand this commercial," she said, and started to furiously flip through the channels. I went into the kitchen and came back with two beers and a whiskey. As I sat down, I gave my sister a beer and then took a sip of my whiskey, followed by a slug of beer. "What's the name of that schizophrenia you used to take care of when we were growing up?" I asked. "Which one?" my sister scoffed. "The one who lived down the street from us. The one who communicated with Hamilton, Ohio by talking to the ceiling. Eva May." "Did she talk to Hamilton every day?" "Oh yeah, all the time. And if Hamilton wasn't talking back, she'd put her underwear on her head and get into bed and completely cover herself up with a sheet and lay there as straight as a board and not answer to anyone. And the only way we could coach her out was with her sweet note." "Sweet note?" "Yeah, that's what she called her vitamin drink. It was the only thing she'd eat. She was super skinny. I mean, like 90 pounds. Thin, as black as a rat's." I took a drink of my beer and looked at the TV where my sister had turned it back to The Price. I wanted to ask more about Eva May, but my sister hushed me and pointed at the TV where the showcase showdown was about to get underway. Later that morning, Vince stopped by with some beer. He and I started drinking while my sister went in the kitchen and cooked us some sausage and eggs. After a while, Vince lit a cigarette from my pack and lit it up. With the cigarette bouncing between his lips, he said, "What movie do you think has been seen by the most people? Wizard of Oz, Star Wars, Titanic?" I stared at the TV where an episode of The Golden Girls was viewed. "Who cares?" I said. "Come on, have a guess." "I don't think so." "Come on." My sister stuck her head out over the bar. "E.T.," she yelled. "E.T.!" I rubbed my forehead with my hand and continued to stare at the TV. "Come on," I said. I dropped my hand in my lap. "All right," I said. "Logan's Run." Vince wrinkled up his forehead. "That futuristic flick? Come on, man, that didn't even show in theaters." "I don't give a fuck if it didn't show in theaters," I said as I reached out and slipped my pack of cigarettes toward me. "It's still my guess." Vince shook his head and blew smoke out of his nose. "Yeah, well, I sure as hell ain't never seen it. Whatever." "Not from beginning to end, I haven't. Whatever." Vince crushed his half-smoked cigarette into the ashtray and started to get up. But my sister came around the bar, carrying two plates of food for me and Vince. "Well, what was it?" she said. "E.T.?" "Oh, who gives a fuck?" Vince said as he took his plate and sat down. Then after taking a bite of the sausage, he said, "This is freezing cold." He dropped his fork onto his plate and shoved it away. "How's that even possible, huh?" My sister and Vince fought a lot, but that was to be expected because my sister had fought with every man she had ever known for more than 24 hours. But one night they had a huge blowout, one that was more fucked up than usual, and I could tell that it was over for good. After that, Vince went out to his car, and my sister went in the bedroom and cried. I went outside to tell Vince to stay the fuck away for good, but somehow I ended up taking a ride with him and picking up some beer. "I'm sick to death of these bitches," he said as he aimlessly steered us through town. "I don't need any of them. Right now, I got three chips that I'm fucking on a regular basis, and there could easily be five others, maybe even 10 others, that I could get back on the team without a moment's notice." It was cold out that night, and It must have been late November or early December because the main street in the town was decorated for Christmas. Hanging from every street lamp, I saw candy canes made from tinsel and sparkly lights. And in front of the library, I saw a manger scene with illuminated plastic figurines resting on a bed of hay. Vince pulled into a parking space alongside the street and we sat there drinking beers and watching the windshield slowly fog up. "You know what I'd like to do," Vince said. "I'd like to get me a video camera and hide it outside my house. And then I'd like to call every one of those bitches and tell them to be at my house at a certain time. And I'd tell them to all wear something nice and bring me a home cooked meal. Then, on the big day, I'd turn on that video camera and leave the country. Go to Mexico or Puerto Rico or something. And then later that night, you could go get the videotape and send it to me. That's exactly what I'd like." Vince laughed and finished off his beer. He then leaned in front of me, opened the glove compartment, pulled out a flask. He took a swig and passed it to me. I took a swig too, and then Vince laughed again. I almost laughed too, because I started thinking about all those women out in front of his house, all dressed up and holding containers of home-cooked food. Then I pictured them all deciding to make the best of it by sitting down on his porch and having a little picnic. And then I thought of Vince getting a videotape of it in the mail. Vince in Mexico or wherever, watching his bitches partake in a potluck on his front porch. That was an image that made me smile. I handed the flask back to Vince, and he raised it in mock toast and then tipped it back for a swig. He then screwed on the cap, stashed it against the crease in the seat, and said, "Cover me," as he suddenly swung open his door. He jumped out of the car and began running toward the manger in front of the library. As soon as he reached it, he plunged his arms into the cradle, yanked at something, struggled for a moment, and then yanked even harder. He then charged back to the car, toward the car, cradling a plastic baby as he was screaming. Let's go," he yelled, even though he was the driver. And then he gunned it as he simultaneously swung the door shut. When I woke the next morning, I was on the couch and my sister was in the Lazy Boy. She was eating ice cream and watching The Price. I think we watched the rest of the show before I said anything. She didn't even provoke me. She hadn't even said a word, but something about the way she was acting got under my skin. "It's the same thing all over again," I said. "The same things that attract you to a man are the exact same things that you end up hating about him. That's how all women are. They want it both ways. They want to hook up with a real man, but then as soon as they have him, they want to cut off his nuts. Well, you can't have it both ways. And if you keep thinking that you can, then you're stupider than I thought." I remember my sister looked angry, like she was going to start yelling at me. But then she just said, I know," and then let out a couple quiet sobs. "I'm not saying Vince was anything special," I said. "In fact, that's the point. He was exactly the same as every other man. But until you see that, this is just going to happen to you again and again, just like it always has." After that, we didn't say any more about it. We just watched TV. Then I got us some beers, and we drank for most of the day. I remember we watched The Monsters, and later we watched Leave It to Beaver. And I think we both laughed pretty hard at those shows. Then, I think we both went to sleep.